Why don't we start with Blue State Digital? Why don't you just tell me what Blue State Digital is and then go to your kind of history?
Absolutely. Blue State Digital is a company that provides tools for running the online aspects of a campaign, for organizing people around a cause, a candidate, an issue, and getting them to take action offline. Mm-hmm. So whether it's having events, in the case of a campaign, it might be a Canvas event where people go and they knock on doors, or a house party where they try to raise money, or getting people just to group themselves to find other folks in their neighborhood, you know, find profiles of people that live near them and link up with them so that they can coordinate activities. The software covers everything from these sort of sophisticated social networking and organizing tools to, you know, the more mundane stuff of a campaign, fundraising, sending mass email, mm-hmm. You know, just keeping the site up and running, content management, all of that kind of stuff. So the company provides, you know, this technology, and we also have a suite of strategic services. And one of the challenges we found in the political space is that there are a lot of organizations that want to use the internet. They mm-hmm. see the power of it. They don't necessarily know how to go about doing it. They have a mission, but they don't know how to translate that into the online world. So in addition to providing them tools to make this work, we also help them at a strategic level. How are you going to write, what are you going to write emails about? What kind of web content do you need? Are you going to do online video? If so, what kind of video? How are you going to mm-hmm. do it? All that kind of stuff. You know, and this is applicable for campaigns, of course, but also in nonprofits that are trying to get people. I mean, we do work with Save Darfur and We Can Solve It, which is, you know, working on the climate crisis, trying to get, you know, how do you get these large organizations to really get people motivated, excited, and engaged online mm-hmm. and offline using the internet as that central hub?
And what sounds like it's distinct as well is that offline component of mobilizing people towards action, you know, using those tools, but also moving that through, that energy through towards action.
That's exactly right. And you know, social networking sites are great, but they, in many ways, tend to be somewhat navel-gazing. You know, mm-hmm. they're very much about me, my universe, my friends. And there's often not a whole lot to move you out of the online world. So what we do is, instead of focusing on how many friends you have or, you know, writing on somebody's wall, we give you tools. We focus on, what are your friends doing? Where, you know, who are they? Are they calling voters? Mm-hmm. Are they going to events? Are they involved in a local group? And we make that and those activities the center of the community on the site.
So it'd be fair to say it's almost issue-centric rather than identity-centric, or something.
Yeah, much more so. I mean, it's issue and action-centric. Yeah.
Well, you know, it's funny because I give talks and I use mybarackobama.com as an example of several things. One being kind of relationships, beat transactions, the way that you're building these types of really strong relationships. I joined within, I think, literally 15 minutes. Somebody from my neighborhood was contacting me about an event, about what to do in my local neighborhood, which I thought was really amazing. It wasn't just about me connecting to the larger campaign of viewer. It was actually the micro campaign that's happening within my region. Mm-hmm. So that was really...
And that's ultimately where, you know, you can... You know, what we're trying to do is not, with our clients, is not help them run one giant national campaign. We're helping them run, you know, thousands and thousands of little local campaigns mm-hmm. that all roll up around a central set of issues or a candidate or a goal. And it's the local stuff that really matters. It's people, it's you knocking on your neighbor's door and saying, hi, you know, my name's Yasha, I live on the next street over and I want to talk to you about Barack Obama, or I want to talk to you about the genocide in Darfur. Those kinds of connections are what actually moves the needle. And mm-hmm. so the more that we can use the internet to enable that sort of person-to-person interaction, action, you know, that's the true power of this, and to be able to do it at scale.
And in a sense, that decentralized network allows you to go places you never could have, right?
Exactly.
You can organize
right.
and empower it very fine grain.
I mean, I remember, you know, as far back as 2004 on the Dean campaign, you know, we had a the blog comments ended up being this sort of community chat mm-hmm. room in mm-hmm. many ways. And, you know, we had a woman who lived in the Texas Panhandle, you know, the reddest part of the state, who was a graphic designer. And she said, you know, the nearest Democrat is 40 miles away, but I really want to get Howard Dean elected. So what she was doing was designing flyers. Now, there wasn't really much point in her handing them out in her neighborhood, but mm-hmm. those flyers were getting used by activists in Iowa and in New Hampshire and in the states where they needed this kind of material. Mm-hmm. So being able to break down those geographic boundaries, opportunities to tap into people, whether it's talking to their neighbors, you know, wherever they are, or whether it's, you know, using their skills and their abilities to help other folks in other parts of the country. You know, all of that becomes possible with the online tools, but you have to create a community that gives people the means and the reason to collaborate, yeah, in order to make that happen.